माई लाइफ स्ट्रगल्स बाय शक्ति मिसेज राम तिलकम फ्रॉम कांचीपुरम इंडिया बाय द शक्ति ओली टीम। आई वर्क एज अ गवर्नमेंट प्राइमरी स्कूल टीचर। आई हैड नो पीस ऑफ माइंड इन माई फैमिली फॉर मेनी ईयर्स, सो आई इन्वॉल्व माई सेल्फ इन डिवोशनल एक्टिविटीज, जॉइंड द साइवर डिवोटीज ऑन देयर पिलग्रिमेज एंड विजिटेड मेनी सीक्रेट प्लेसेस। Since I didn't own a house, I relocated at least 20 to 25 times and encountered many struggles that words cannot describe. There were times when I couldn't afford to pay rent. I had 5 children and my husband did not have any income. In this situation, my 14-year-old girl passed away due to chickenpox. My 2 sons didn't show any interest in studies. With no peace in life, I even thought of committing suicide. There was a discourse about Melmaruthur Adiparashakti Amma and the significance of Irumudi in a nearby Shiva temple. Incidentally, I took part in that and heard them say that no matter what the problem was, pray to Amma, observe fasting and offer Irumudi and you will see the benefits. So in the year 1983, along with my 2 children, I wore the Shakti Malai and went to offer Irumudi by walking to the temple. Being a diabetic, both my legs swelled up, but they subsided in 2 days after returning home. That year, I built a small hut on my own by selling a few ornaments and availing a bank loan. My elder daughter was suffering from fits right from the age of 1. Despite the many treatments, there was no improvement. I took her along with me for Irumudi by walking the distance to the temple. When we were going around the neem tree in the temple, she started to rotate her head, jump and dance as though possessed by devil. I was devastated by this. I took the holy ash and the kumkum I had and pressed my hands on her head, keeping them under my palm, and shouted, "Om Shakti, Om Shakti." She became normal. It has been 10 years since and there is no sign of the fits in her again. She also has offered 10 Irumudi by Amma's grace. Later, she even got married and has a son. When he was 3 years old, suddenly the child's legs became paralyzed from a fever. Her husband was an atheist, although she was devoted to Amma. One day, she brought the child to me at midnight after treating him at the hospital. At that hour, I lit the lamp, held the child in my hands and started to read the Shakti Kavasam. I prayed to Amma for him to regain his ability to walk. What would my daughter do with an alcoholic husband and a disabled child? Also, I prayed to Amma to forgive her of any sins and committed to making the child offer 9 Irumudi if his legs would return to normalcy that same night. We cried and prayed until late that night and finally fell asleep. When we woke up in the morning, we were stunned to see the child climb up and jump from a chair on his own. Tears of joy started to roll down my cheeks. I offered my thanks to Amma for her immediate response. The child completed 9 years of offering Irumudi. Now, he is in his 11th year of doing Irumudi and is pursuing the ritual by walking to the temple. Isn't that a miracle? 15 years ago, I frequently wished to do Abhishegam and get Arulvaku from Amma to solve my family's issues. But the circumstances at the time did not permit that. But when I did get a chance, I listed my wishes on a piece of paper and tucked it in my sari. I went and sat in front of Amma. Before I could open my mouth, Amma herself said, "I will situate your sons in their profession and provide them with education." Beyond that, I didn't even feel the need to ask for anything else. As Amma promised, she blessed one of my sons with his own business. My younger son is pursuing his master's degree. The location where I built my house was not very peaceful as there were neighborhood fights, and we even had to go to the police station. I am unable to sell the house till date. So I bought a plot in Pillayar Palayam in Kanchipuram and built a house. Every Thursday, I observed fast and prayed to our Guru. I pray in my house as done at the mandram. I chant the 1008 and 108 mantras every day. One night, I had a dream where I saw a stage and a throne. I saw Amma sitting on that throne. There was a crowd of people in front of the stage. Some discourse was going on at the time. I happened to go near the stage, and there I touched the lotus feet of Amma. Lifting his hands and blessing me, Amma said, "I am so happy to accept your puja, the fasting and your devotion towards me." I spoke to Amma and told her that I was not too fond of the house that I was living in and that I would like to get Amma's permission to live in the newly built home. But Amma vanished without responding. Though I was happy that I received Amma's blessings, I was upset because I couldn't get an answer in my dream. I rented the newly built house to a tenant. The tenant complained that a shadow-like figure threatened them while they were sleeping and that his wife had frequent miscarriages. I gave him 6 to 7 pictures of our guru and asked him to stick it all around the house. I also advised him to embed a pendant of Amma in the front entrance and to light the frankincense every Tuesday and Friday. I took some holy water every time I came to Melmaruthur and asked them to sprinkle it all around the house. I took them along with me to offer Irumudi. Now they don't have any such issues in the house and they have given birth to a girl child. On seeing us prospering, someone had done black magic against us, the ill effects of which paralyzed my right hand, and my younger daughter suffered from diarrhea. She had become as thin as a skeleton. There was no support from my husband, who never contributed financially but instead made fun of us for visiting the temple. I chanted the Mula Mantiram and cried when I heard a voice say, "For 3 Amavasya or no moon days, come to the Atharana Kali's sanctorum and offer rice flakes, betel leaves and nut and a lamp made out of rice flour. Also come around with lemon to remove the evil eye and throw it on the backside." I did it and now my hand is alright. I also made my daughter light a lemon lamp during the 3 full moon days at the Nagapedam at the Melmaruthur temple. After that, she became alright as well. In this Kali Yuga or the last era, Melmaruthur Amma is our only god and resort. That is the absolute truth. Om Shakti.